As you see, full speed, time to short circuit the wires, okay?
It's very, very cool.
Hi guys, this what you see is a permanent magnet large DC motor, okay? Now guys, I got this motor with this chain gear, you see? But I replaced this with a pulley from a washing machine and it fits almost perfectly, okay? The wires coming out from the motor are pretty long, you see? Now let's come to the label, and here it says model ZY1020, voltage is 24 volts DC, rated speed is 2500 RPM, output 500 watts, and the current rated is 26.7 amperes, which is pretty high. It is used in e-bikes. So guys, the weight as you can see is pretty heavy, 4 kgs, okay? Now guys, this is a 12 volts lithium ion battery pack, 40 amperes, which I created from old laptop battery cells. So I'm going to use this to run the DC motor and test it. These are the two DC terminals, positive and negative, red positive, black negative. Yeah. And guys, please note that this motor is 24 volts and I am going to run it at just 12 volts DC. Red will be connected to red. Okay, now comes the black. Okay, get ready guys. You see, super high torque. No wonder that it is being used for e-bikes. Once more, you will see it jump. Pretty smooth workout, although the pulley is a little bit wobbly because it's not for this motor. I just attached it for rope rotation testing. Now comes the no load current flow to this motor at 12 volts input. Let's do that check. Let's point it towards 10 ampere mode, okay? And of course, this will need to be placed like this. Yeah, with this being done, let's connect it. Okay, you will see the no load amps. Super high no load amperes. And that too when these thin wires from the multimeter are connected in between the motor and the battery. Once more. 1.6 amps free running. So at present, the losses are 1.6 multiplied by 12. 19.2 watts loss. So loss is at present 19.2 watts at an input of just 12 volts. Let's increase the input to 24 volts and then see how much no load input current it takes. So guys, here what you see is this DC power supply, which you have already seen in many of my previous videos. Yeah, output volts 9 volt to 24 volts, 3 amperes. So I'm going to use this to check the no load current that it takes at 24 volts. So let's turn it on. 24.3 volts DC. Let's first check if it is able to run this motor directly, because the current rating is not much to handle this much load. You saw? So guys, as you saw that at the start, the motor was running very slowly, even though I fed it 24 volts DC from this power supply. That was because the starting current flow to start the motor is always very high. It is almost equivalent or even more than the full load current that a motor faces because of the moment of inertia of rest. But guys, as the motor gained speed, the current to the motor started decreasing and it became more and more probable for this power supply to handle that current, and thus it attained full speed with jerk. Once again guys, slow speed and then very fast speed, unstoppable. Yeah, very fast. Now guys, let me also show you regenerative braking at the same time. Okay, first I'm going to charge this motor with this
power supply, and when it attains full speed, I'm going to short circuit the wires coming out from this motor together. And then there will be high spark, and the motor will try all its power in stopping, because of which it will jump. So let's do that. As you see, full speed, time to short circuit the wires, okay? You see, it's very, very cool. Once again, full speed, weight of this motor is 4 kg, somewhere around 4 kg. Okay, it jumps, and that effect was because the armature and the motor inside gets locked because of the short circuit of these two wires, which acts something like a disc braking system, a disc brake of a motorbike or a car. Very cool thing. Another.
Whoa. I believe the timing was pretty good, because of which all the torque hit the motor armature, because of which it bounced back. So that was the regenerative braking effect. Now let's proceed to the next part.
And guys, at the same time, let's also see if this motor produces enough power in its regenerative braking to light up this car headlamp bulb. Obviously it is not working right now. Okay, let's run it, start running it. Oops, sorry. Now, yo, again. So yeah, it is actually generating enough electricity in the braking mode. That's how, when you apply brakes in electric bikes or motorcycles, that braking generating power can be fed back to the power source battery or any other appliance you want to feed. Cool. Now guys, enough chit chat about the regenerative braking. Let's measure the current at 24 volts, the no load current it takes. Okay. The final wire, and now you are going to see how much current it takes with no load. So the no load current, guys, is only 2 amperes now, okay? So at present, the loss is somewhere around 24 watts. Now let's put some load to it. You see, amperes are increasing as I'm pressing my finger to the pulley. 3.25, even 4, but my hand starts burning, fingers start burning because of the friction. Now guys, there is one more thing that needs to be tested: the regenerative braking current of this motor. Okay, so let's quickly connect this wire to this terminal. Yeah, okay, and then you will see the peak current. Oh, it was 9.78 amperes, almost 10 amperes. Whoa, that was insane. I am going to test that once again. It needs to be tested. Very high current. Oh, now I'm excited. Okay. 10.45 amperes regenerative braking current. So guys, now comes the time for current testing. Pointing the meter towards 10 amperes current mode and flashing 0. Okay, so let's give it a spin. 0.82. Let's take it 1 amps, 1.32, 2.15, 2.79. Yeah, 2.79 amps was the max I could do with hand rotation. Now let's go to rope rotation testing. So yeah, the rope has been wound on the pulley. Let's pull it. Whoa, 8.84 amperes. 8.84 amperes, and I didn't even give my full try. Once again. keep watching the display screen. 11.15 amperes, pretty good DC generator guys, very high current output. Let's check the generated voltage now. Pointing towards 20 volts DC. Okay. Keep watching the display screen. Volts DC. Again. Okay. Volts, almost 20 volts DC, the max I could do with rope rotation. Almost close to 24 volts DC, the rated voltage. Now let's go for the bulb glowing test with rope rotation and hand rotation. Okay. Keep watching the bulb. The bulb glow pretty bright. Let's keep it like this so that it is visible sideways also. Okay, so guys, that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching it. Please hit like and don't forget to share and subscribe, and link for that product will be provided in the description. It's available on Banggood, so don't forget to check it out. See you soon in my next video.